إيدي إشمات بإسحاق أبرام بلطيفة إيدي إشمات زي زفير ببت إيدي إشمات
خبا
خبا بات يهودا إيدي إشمات موشي موشي بن
René. Daniel Samuel for the phone.
Mm-hmm.
Raphael Ben
Nishmat. Raphael Ben
Raphael.
Ben Raphael. Rifuat Shilima. Tonight it's Rosh Chodesh Nissan. Rosh Chodesh Nissan is a month, very, very special month. It's a month of Nisim. That's why all the month we don't do Techanon. Why we don't do Techanon? Because most of the month it's holiday. Because don't forget, we did the inauguration of the Mishkan on Rosh Chodesh Nisan. We did the inauguration of the Mishkan. And then, 3 days after, the inauguration of the Mishkan lasted 12 days. Then, 2 days later, it's Pesach. Pesach starts the 14th of Nisan in the night. So after there is all the Chag, so most of the month is holiday. So because most of the month is holiday, so we don't do Techanun. And what it's incredible is today we have no Beit HaMikdash. Yes, well, there is no Beit HaMikdash. So why we do something in memory of the Mishkan? It's a question that you never heard in your life. I mean, the Mishkan, okay, it was the holiday of the Mishkan. It was the Simcha of the Mishkan when they built it. Seder. Now, there is no Mishkan. Because there is no Mishkan, why? Where to? No. Okay, only on Rosh Chodesh Nisan, we should not do the Techanun, because it's Rosh Chodesh. But after the Rosh Chodesh Nisan, the second day of Nisan, we can do Techanun, because there is no Beit HaMikdash. There is no Beit HaMikdash. I mean, it's not a holiday. Because the Jews, they inaugurated the Mishkan on the first of Nisan, and it lasted 12 days, because of that, we don't do Techanun. If the Mishkan was not destroyed, I understand. But now there is no Mishkan. Do we do a special day for the day that Shlomo HaMelech, he built the Beit HaMikdash? No. No. Because he built the Beit HaMikdash, Shlomo HaMelech, he inaugurated the Beit HaMikdash during the holidays. So it was the holidays. So on the holidays, there is no Techanun. So why we don't do Techanun today? I mean, for me, we should do Techanun on Nisan. I will never forget. One day, I was sitting and I said to myself, why we don't do Techanun? Why? Suddenly, it's true. You know, Chabad, they give, each synagogue, I remember it was in France, they put, you know, the Sikha of the Rebbe, you know. So, I took one, That's what we did. And he said in his sikha, in his lecture, that because of the inauguration of the Beit HaMikdash, we don't do Tachanun from Rosh Chodesh Nisan till the end of the month. And he carry on. And because after the 12th day of Nisan, there is Pesach. And Pesach, till after Pesach, there is no Tachanun. Tachanun is this. We do Hatati, Abiti, Pashati. And then, once Pesach finished, so most of the month is finished. So for a few days left, we don't do Tachanun. That's what the Rebbe said. That's what the Gemara said. So I accept it. But today I have a question. Now, maybe 50 years later, I have a question. Why we don't do Tachanun today? Because the Jews did the inauguration of the Mishkan on the first of the earth of Nisan till the 12th of Nisan. Okay, that was in the desert. But now, it's a few thousand years later. Why? There is no Beit HaMikdash, there is no Mishkan. So I think you should do Tachanun. And the halacha is, we don't do Tachanun. We don't do Chatati, Aviti, Pashati, we don't do that. All the month. Because most of the majority of the days of the month was without Tachanun. So after Pesach, for a few days later, there is no Tachanun. Okay. I want to tell you a beautiful story. Today, the only souvenir we have from the Beit HaMikdash today is the menorah. We have no souvenir for nothing today. Nada. The only souvenir we have today is the menorah. We don't have the Aron HaKodesh. We don't have the Mizbeah. We have nothing, but once a year we do Hanukkah. Hanukkah, it's the famous miracle that happened in the Beit HaMikdash, that after the war against the Greek, they wanted to light the menorah, and there was no oil. So they started to look for oil, and they found a small boat of oil. For one day, it lasted, and they light the menorah, and a big miracle happened. The menorah was on for 8 days. 8 days and 8 nights. So, every year, we do the menorah. So, this is the only souvenir we have from the Beit HaMikdash. We have nothing else. What it is, the secret of the menorah? Well, my friend, the circuit of the menorah, I found out that the circuit of the menorah is not only it represents the Torah, the menorah, the light of the Torah, but it represents as well Shabbat. Don't forget this. The menorah represents Shabbat. What the meaning? The Binish Hai said, you have the menorah, you have three branches on the right, you have three branches on the left, and you have one in the middle. The three branches on the right, it's Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. This three branches on the left, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. The one in the middle is Shabbat. That means Shabbat and the sixth branch, they are looking at the middle one. To tell you, to teach you that all the bracha of the 6 day week come from Shabbat. Baruch Hashem, we don't work on Shabbat. We eat our children. and we go to synagogue. And we rest. What about work? Hashem. We have emuna. On Shabbat, we have emuna. You see people open shops on Shabbat. Today, the best business is Shabbat. What about you? I close. Why? Well, Shabbat. What about Parnaso? Parnasa? Parnasa? Hashem. Hashem give Parnasa. All the 6 day week, they got the bracha from your emuna that when you keep Shabbat. Respect Shabbat. You have the bracha all the week. I promise you. I'm telling you this. I'm going to my 73-year-old, and I can assure you, I've been receiving people since mostly maybe 50 years. I know billions of stories. I know people that they become billionaires, and today they have not $1. I know one thing. All those who made money on Shabbat, they lost it at the end of their life. If they didn't lose it, their children lost it. I know somebody, I know thousands of, but this somebody, I will never forget it. Because I told him, Paul, stop. Paul, he used to live next to me, Lyon. And every Shabbat, he has a beautiful Mercedes. And he had a few shops in Lyon. And one day I told him, Paul, you don't need money. You have Blé Nara. You have, at that time, he had Blé Nara. And he said, but I have to work. You don't need to work. You have enough money for a year, for a generation. You don't need. Unfortunately, he lost everything. He sold all his companies. It was newspapers. It was one of the richest men of France or Europe. And unfortunately, he bought, you know, he sold his company very, very expensive. And he bought, he invested his money in stock market. And he was losing. Today, I give him money to eat. Today, I send him money for Pesa. Kim Hadi Pesa. I send him box of food today. There is no bracha from the money of Shabbat. There is no bracha. For those people who did not know, Hashem forgive them. But for those who know, it's a problem because they know. So my friend, the money of Shabbat is no bracha. Why? Because that branch in the middle, it gives the bracha for all the 6 days a week. Now, we saw on the Torah last week, Parashat Vayakhel, the Pasuk said, Sheshet yamim te'ase melacha. 6 days te'ase. That means the 6 days will work for you. The Torah didn't say, 6 days you work the Shabbat to stop. No. The Torah said, 6 days, the days they will do the work for you. The Torah did not say, Sheshet yamim ta'ase, you do. The Torah said, te'ase, that the 6 days they will do the work for you. When you respect Shabbat. So that means, all the bracha you get it, when you respect Shabbat. All the bracha, you get it. So, this is why today, this is my what I understand the Torah. The only souvenir we have today is the menorah. Why? Because even if the Beit HaMikdash will be destroyed, Shabbat will not be destroyed. Shabbat will be celebrated Shabbat every day, every week. So at least, you will remember, wherever you are, that the menorah, she follow you. Shabbat follow you. The menorah remind you Shabbat. Expect Shabbat, and the Shabbat we do all the work for you. The Shabbat we do all the job for you. The Shabbat we give you parnasa. The Shabbat we do everything for you. Just remember, keep Shabbat. So the menorah. The menorah represents Shabbat. The only thing, the menorah. Today we don't have Beit HaMikdash, but we're in exile. Oof, we live in Argentina. I live in Brazil. I live in France. I have to work Shabbat. The menorah reminds you, Shabbat. You go to Rome, you have the Ark of Titus. What do you have there? The menorah. Even Titus warned you, hey, I'm not a Jew, but I know one thing. Your blessing comes from Shabbat. You know, the Ark of Titus, you have there the menorah. The menorah reminds you, wherever you are, the menorah. And that's why Hashem, he did a miracle for the menorah. Why Hashem, he didn't do another miracle? Why only the menorah? Because the menorah represents Shabbat. And Shabbat is still Mashiach will come. When Mashiach will come, there'll be no more Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. All the 6 days weeks, it will be like Shabbat. It will be like Olam Haba. In Olam Haba, there is no Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday in Olam Haba. There is only Shabbat. On Olam Haba, it's Shabbat. Your father, Arba Shalom. There, all the time is Shabbat. You know, up there, the Neshamot, the souls, they don't know what day we are today. You know how they know what day we are today? Because for them, it's Shabbat all the time. You know how they know what day? There is some malachim who sing to Hashem, this is the song for Sunday. So they know it's Sunday. So the malachim sing, this is, and because we pray here, we pray like today, it's Wednesday, yes or no? So today we pray the Shir Shayu Alviim Umrim Al Abducha Yom Revi'i B'Shach. This is the song that the Leviim were doing in the Beit HaMikdash on Wednesday. So when we see that song, so they take it to Hashem. So the soul, the Neshamot up there, they know what day it is. Otherwise, they will not know what, because there, you know, on Shabbat, Me'en Olam Haba, Shabbat is like Olam Haba. So that way HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he did a big miracle for the menorah. So always we will talk about the menorah. Look, take a book, any book that you want. You open the book, a tefillah book. You open the tefillah book, you see there a menorah. Before Baruch Shamar, there is a menorah. That means every day you think of the menorah, 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 all the time, menorah, menorah, menorah. Chanukah, menorah, menorah. Why menorah? To remind you, hey, it's Wednesday today. If you keep Shabbat, today will be blessed. Today will be blessed. Bemet, I'm telling you, I live miracles with, during my life with only with Shabbat. On Shabbat, the koach of Shabbat, you have no idea. Now, my friend, I have to tell you this. This is the reason now why Hashem, he wants that even that we are in exile, the Shabbat reminds us, when we see the menorah, it reminds us, hey, not because you're in exile, so you can do whatever you want to do. No. The bracha will come. The menorah reminds you that the bracha comes when you respect Shabbat. I want to tell you a beautiful story of Rav Moshe Feinstein. Beautiful story. Bemet, he's a big tzaddik, Rav Moshe Feinstein. I don't know if you heard about him. He was in America. Rav Moshe Feinstein, when he came after the Shoah to America, a lot of people with that they lost their family in the Shoah. I mean, now they came here, they work very, very, very. So one day, Rav Moshe Feinstein, he said, he saw a lot of people, religious people, their children, they don't respect Shabbat. So Rav Moshe Feinstein, he was shocked. Why people that they pray with him and they are religious, their sons, they don't respect Shabbat? Why? Why did not respect Shabbat? So one day, he started to do his own investigation. He called, hey, Moshe, what's up? How are you? Oh, Hashem, you work? No. Why you don't work? Because where I work, they want me to work on Shabbat. And because I don't work Shabbat, they throw me. And you? How are you? Baruch Hashem. He saw a few people very, very sad. What about your children? Well, this is another problem. They are with goyot. They don't keep nothing. So Moshe Feinstein started to ask, how come people that they were saved from the Shoah and they came to America and they respect Shabbat and they've been thrown from the work because of Shabbat, how come that their children, they disconnect themselves from the Torah? Why? You have an answer for that. That was the question of Rav Moshe Feinstein. And Rav Moshe Feinstein gave an answer. He said, those children, it's not their fault. It's the fault of the parents. Because when the parents came on Shabbat, sitting at the table, they were sad. Why they were sad? So the children, Papa, why you are sad? Ah, they threw me from my job. Why, Papa? Because I don't want to work on Shabbat. And because I don't want to work on Shabbat, they throw me. A big problem. So now the children, what it is their first thought? So the problem is Shabbat. So we work on Shabbat. If the parents, we will say to the children, well, Baruch Hashem, they throw me from, because I respect Shabbat, I'm happy. So the children will respect Shabbat. But because they were sad, if you do a mitzvah, do it or don't do it. Do it or don't do it. Do it well and don't complain when you do it. If you complain why you do it, so it's like you did nothing. Do it or don't do it. So the menorah reminds you that when you do a mitzvah, do it well. You keep Shabbat, good. Don't complain if you have a problem because of Shabbat. Don't blame Shabbat. The father-in-law of my son, Rabbi Yoel, when he was a baby, he got burned with the fire, with the hot water of Shabbat. And the mother came to my father for a bracha. And my father told the father-in-law of Rabbi Yoel, Madam, take the water of the Shabbat and throw it on your son. Throw the water. She told him, Rabbi, because of Shabbat, my son is in the hospital. You tell me to take this hot water and throw it on my son. Rabbi, how can I do that? So my father told her, this is the way to correct the sin that you did. Because since your son got burned, you complain about Shabbat. So now I want to show you that Shabbat, the Shabbat who burned your son, the Shabbat will give refuah Hashemah to your son. And that's what she did. She took the water, who was hot. She went to the room of the father-in-law of my son, Rabbi Yoel, and she thought, and they catch her. They wanted to take her to prison. And she started screaming, and Baruch Hashem, the baby, Yosef, he woke up, and they find nothing. He has only one sign, and he's in his body. So my father then he told her, next time don't complain about Shabbat. Or do it or don't do it. My friend, this is my Dvartora. Now you understand. Now you understand why there is no Tachanun. We ask a question. Why we don't do Tachanun from Rosh Chodesh Nisan till Pesach? Okay, the first day is Rosh Chodesh. We don't do Tachanun. But after do Tachanun, why don't we don't do Tachanun? Well, my friend, because the month of Nisan, is the month that give bracha to all the year. The month of Nisan, it reminds you there is only Nisim. Because if you do Tachanun, that means that you have a problem. Hashem, forgive me. I did that. Nisan. The first day of Nisan, Hashem forgive all your sin. You are a new one. So you don't need to complain. You don't need to say, I did that. That's it. This is why the first day of Nisan, to remind you, this is the month of miracles. This is the month of miracles. You want miracles? Nisan. You want miracles? Nisan. The month of Nisan. And that's why the month of Nisan, it reminds you, it was our liberty, our liberation from Egypt. Can you imagine what it is the month of Nisan for us? When the month of Nisan begin, the Jews, or the other Jews in Egypt, they were counting the days. That's it. They smelled. Like today we smell Mashiach. Today we smell the Geula. I promise you. We smell it. Hebli Mashiach. It's like a perfume. You smell the perfume. Today we smell it. But sometimes you can't believe it. How can you smell Mashiach? There is no perfume. He said, I smell perfume, but there is no perfume. I smell Mashiach. Who is Mashiach? This is war. This is Emuna. With Emuna, you smell what you don't smell. With Emuna, you smell the perfume, and there is no perfume. And you smell the perfume. This is Mashiach. So when Nisan comes, the first day of Nisan, that's it. B'Nisan Igalu, B'Nisan Atidi Ligayel. We said that on Nisan we'll be liberated, and on Nisan we'll be, Be'ezat Hashem, liberated. So we have Emuna. So that's why our Emuna is beginning from tonight. That Mashiach is going to come. There's going to be liberation. So because of this, there is no Tachanun. I would like to ask you a halacha. The day of Mashiach will come. Who will do Tachanun?
No.
So for us, the first day of Nisan, that's it. It's the Geula. So there is no Tachanun.